Hey everyone, Bianca Cervantes here, and welcome to the new set of Workforce Wednesday. We're here to bring you the weekly highlights of everything that's going on at Workforce Solutions Borderplex.
Hello, my name is Rebecca Eid, but everyone just calls me Becca. Together, we're B squared. This week, we are thrilled to be working with the CTE program at the Career Center at Riverside High School. So we want to give a huge thanks to them for letting us get our feet wet in the studio.
We wanted to fill you in on the HireAbility event we had earlier this month. It was one of the best events of the year by far, and Becca's going to tell you why.
As you know, October is National Disability Employment Awareness Month. This event was entirely dedicated to that observance.
At the beginning of October, Workforce Solutions Borderplex teamed up with several agencies to host Texas HireAbility, a very special event dedicated to people with disabilities.
So HireAbility is, in general, the way that we talk or the way that we describe programs for individuals with disabilities that are wanting to transition into the workforce. So students or adults that have barriers to employment, this program allows them to transition into the workforce and obtain real-world experience.
The event was aimed at educating local employers, human resource professionals, and business stakeholders about the best practices for creating an inclusive workforce.
We had this event, we asked those, you know, tough questions, if you will, and we provided them with examples from local employers that have been doing it for a long time and have some really good best practices and good examples that they can share.
The forum was held at the beautiful El Paso Zoo in partnership with the Governor's Committee on People with Disabilities, the Texas Workforce Commission, Texas Workforce Solutions Vocational Rehabilitation Services, and of course Workforce Solutions Borderplex. In notable attendance were our three TWC commissioners, Brian Daniel, Chairman and Commissioner representing the public, Julian Alvarez III, Commissioner representing Labor, and Aaron Demerson, Commissioner representing Employers. Several prominent employers from El Paso were also present.
We really reach out to the community. We look for opportunities for us to connect with people with disability. It's not about the disability, it's about the ability that they can bring to the organization. And then it's really about matching them with the right position at the time that they're looking for a job.
The co-owner of Proper Print Shop, who was awarded and recognized for hiring two student interns with disabilities through our Summer Earn and Learn program, also weighed in on the importance of hiring people with disabilities.
If we make our processes more accessible, it isn't just beneficial to those, you know, with disabilities, but it makes for good business processes all around.
A job fair with an emphasis on hiring people with disabilities was held in conjunction with the forum that benefited more than 20 potential new hires.
Our next job fair is on November 7th, hiring Red, White, and You. Employers will be hiring military vets, but the public is also invited to attend. You can talk to over 80 employers, and yes, they will be hiring on the spot.
There you have it, folks, our first edition of Workforce Wednesday from the Career Center at Riverside High School.
Thanks to the team and to YISD for hosting us, and thank you for tuning in. Next week, in the spirit of Disability Awareness Month, we will learn more about Project Search at the Hospitals of Providence.
Wishing you a great week from Workforce Solutions Borderplex, where we work for you.